That's how we already know.
When it's here, my dog will probably do it for Louis Bell. That's just all he know, he don't know nothing else. I tried to show him. Yeah. I tried to show him. Yeah. 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 Gone on you with the pick and roll. Yellow flame, he in sicko mode.
Way too formal, y'all know I don't follow suit. Stacy Dash, low cities, cause ain't got a clue.
Me. second that I see you. You won't be surprised, it happens every time, it's nothing new. It's always on a night like tonight. I thank God you can read my mind. Cause when you look at me with those eyes, I'm speechless, staring at you standing there in that dress. What it's doing to me ain't a secret, cause watching you is all that I can do. And I'm speechless.
What y'all looking at?
Just get something to me. And I've been in a daze ever since the day that we met. You take the breath out of my lungs, can't even fight it. And all of the words out of my mouth without even trying. And
together today in the presence of God Almighty to witness the union of Gamal Atiba Gordon and Allison Lee Foreman. Who gives this woman to marry this man?
Mom did. My mother did. Don't stay home.
Okay, would you join us in prayer? We come before you to commit this sacred matrimonial ceremony into your holy hands. You are the omniscient, all-knowing God who orchestrated this union for your glory. You knew the exact time their paths would cross and prepared their hearts to be sealed by a love that brought them to this defining moment. It is only by the strength of your mighty power that they will make vows to one another today and be able to keep them. Blessings to their lovely daughters that make the family blend as a mighty fortress and a power to be reckoned with. Blessings to their parents and guardians who, by the grace, raise two unique individuals that are fully equipped for the task ahead. Blessings to all of you that came today, who are faithful witnesses of the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Spirit of the living God, omnipresent Lord of glory, take full control of this union today and forevermore. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Gamal and Allison, there are no other human ties that are more tender and beautiful than the ones that you will make today. No vows are more sacred than yours that you assume in the face of God Almighty. The institution of marriage was ordained by God, not only for the procreation, but for the foundation of the family and the society as a whole. From the rib of Adam, the closest part to his heart, God made the woman, Eve. And he said, now the Lord God said in Genesis 2:18, it is not good, it is not beneficial for the man to be alone. I will make him a helper, one who balances him, a counterpart who is suitable and complimentary for him. To the man, he instructs him to leave his parents and to cleave to his wife. In Genesis 2:24, therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother and shall cleave, glue, be cemented together unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. And this is summed up and best understood from the Greek word gameo, which is the word for marriage. And it corresponds to our English word, gem. Hallelujah. Marriage is like a precious gem that grows under pressure, and in the fires of adversity, it endures. The word gameo also means to fuse together. This fusion is God's design for marriage, that two would become one flesh, permanently fused together, making you both inseparable. This is why he says in Mark 10:9, what therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder or separate. In other words, God has ordained your union. Keeping him in the center will assure you of his success. This will require keeping everybody out of your marriage but God. Today you are affirming your love for one another through the holy estate of matrimony before God and before all of these witnesses. This is the true manifestation of divine love. You have your vows. This is your time.
Hello, everyone. Let me start off first by saying that I know, you know, love is a physical thing and can be a physical thing, and you connect in different ways. And I first connected with Allison from the heart. I then connected with Allison by the mind. And these are things that I know will always last. All things are done by Christ and God. Allison, my love, my companion, my friend, and my equal in all things. You know me better than anyone else in the world, and somehow you still manage to love me. Seriously. Through these vows, I pledge my faith and love to you. I promise to encourage your compassion because that is what makes you unique and wonderful. I promise to nurture your dreams because through them shines your soul. I promise to be a partner in parenthood and an ally in conflict by helping you to shoulder all challenges, for there is nothing we can do or can face as long as we stand together. I promise to be your partner in all things, not possessing you, but working with you as a part of a whole. Lastly, I promise you perfect love, trust, for one lifetime with you could never be enough. Through God, all things are possible. This is my sacred vow to you. Love them all.
All right, I can do this. Try it again. Gamal, G, my Otis. First, I'm so excited to be here, but more importantly, I'm so proud to be standing here today. Proud of us, our girls, you, and me.
I don't hurt.
I wasn't the little girl that planned my entire wedding out. But I knew exactly what type of person I wanted to marry. Someone that was funny, caring, supportive, hardworking, loving, and knowledgeable. And you were all of those things and more. When we first met, we were both honest with what we wanted. I told you I needed affection, affirmation, appreciation, and attention. From day one, you have made every effort to give me those things. You have become my best friend. You make me smile every day. You've helped me arrive here today, ready to be your wife. I appreciate you so much. Your effort matches my effort. You give the kind of loyalty I give. You are my sounding board, my calm, and my support. I'm so ready for us to move forward together and continue to build our strong family. I can't begin to explain how grateful I am to have you in mine and the girls' lives, but what I can do is make a promise to you. I promise to be your friend. I will push you to continue to be great and do great things. I will tell you when I think you're wrong and when you're right, but only sometimes begrudgingly. And being your friend, I will help you through it all. I promise to be your partner. the person that without question will be there for any and everything. I will more than likely ask a lot of questions while I'm there, but I'll be there. I promise to be the best mom and bonus mom I can be to our girls. While I have not been in Ari and Dion's lives since birth, I love them wholeheartedly. I'm so happy to be able to be another person to love and care for them the same way that you love and care for Kendall and Cam. I promise to be your wife. I willingly submit myself to you. And no, that doesn't mean my voice and opinion won't be heard, but I trust in you and all that you do and will do for our family. I love you. I need you.
Wow. I have all of us crying in here.
Yeah.
Come on.
Will you take Allison
as your wedded wife to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her just as Christ loved the church and gave himself for her? Will you love her as your own body? Will you comfort her, honor her, and keep her? Will you stand together with her by the grace of God and under the blood of Jesus Christ to overcome any and all challenges that may come against you, and forsaking all others, will you keep yourself only for her as long as you both shall live?
I do and will.
Allison, will you take them all as your wedded husband to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you submit to him as unto the Lord? Will you love, honor, respect, reverence, and obey him? We had this conversation. Well, you know now what it means, right?
Yes.
The rest of them have to figure it out. And obey him as your head. Will you be subject to him in everything, just as the church is subject to Christ? Will you stand together with him by the grace of God and under the blood of Jesus Christ to overcome any and all challenges that may come your way? Forsaking all others, will you keep yourself only from him so long as you boast from him?
I do, and I will.
You're easy.
He has the rings.
No, I have. No, you did. Don't play. Don't play.
That's not funny. You played it really well because you were going in it for a while.
All right, this one's mine, and this one's so.
A ring is more than a symbol of your marriage. It symbolizes authority, protection, and identification. It is a seal of the vows you have made to one another. The ring is circular, with no beginning or end. So God, too, has perfect love for you and wants you to love one another in his never-ending grace and love. These rings are made of gold and diamonds. Gold is a precious metal that has been purified by fire. It symbolizes the fact that you are precious in God's sight, and you are precious in the sight of your mate. It also symbolizes your commitment to stand together through and against all challenges and any type of opposition that may come your way. The ring symbolizes your ability through Christ Jesus to withstand the challenges of life. With Jesus Christ as your anchor and guide, you will not be consumed by any difficulties in life. You won't even be scorched. Not a hair of your head will be burned, and you won't even smell like smoke. The diamond is also precious. It is the most durable substance known to man. The diamond is formed under pressure, tremendous pressure, in the bowels of the earth. It is able to withstand pressure, as you two will also be able to do together. Thus, the diamond symbolizes your commitment and your ability through Christ Jesus to stand together against all challenges and overcome them and overcome any pressure that may come your way. Gamal, while you're placing the ring on Allison's finger, repeat after me. I give you this ring, Allison.
I give you this ring, Allison.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And with it pledge.
And with it pledge.
My loyalty and devotion.
My loyalty and devotion.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
To Allison, repeat after me. I give you this ring, Gamal.
I give you this ring, Gamal.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And with it.
And with it.
Pledge my loyalty and devotion.
Pledge my loyalty and devotion.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I now declare, by the power invested in me, in the state of Maryland, to pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
We the best music.
Yeah. Jump over there. Go, go, go.
Every year for like 10. Pregnant with my mom's, doctor told her it was slim. Was bedridden for 9 months, but gave birth in the end. Pops turned 60, he proud what we done. In one generation, he came from Africa young. He said he met my mom's at the Century Club. Los Angeles love, kinda like Hustle and Book. Money turned 10.
Clap it up for the groomsmen right now. Tonight. They paid a top dollar for this. Ladies and gentlemen,
is sick. Everybody clap it up for Maul. So I'm going to count to three. I want everybody in this building to say "ah" when the music drop, okay? For the cameras, we're going to make a movie tonight. 1, 2, 3.
What? here. That's so beautiful. Y'all, yes, escort your wife to her. Yes, I love it.
Hey Allison, welcome to the family. I know you and Gamal are going to be a great couple, and this is it for you guys. This is the first marriage and the last and only marriage you're going to have. I love you both.
Express what she wants or expects, and that worked well for Karen and I. sitting on the couch in my condo, which she has now, talking about what we each wanted out of our prospective relationships. Allison knew immediately. She was describing someone supportive, who helps her grow, and was committed and affectionate. But above all, she kept using the word partner. Not long after this conversation, she went on her first date with the mom. And it became clear almost immediately that she had found exactly what she had been looking for, her partner. I have not gotten to spend a ton of time with the mom, but whenever I do see him, I'm immediately put in a good mood. He exudes a warmth and a patience that balances and calms Allison. They have navigated the beginning stages of dating, each with children of their own, blending their families, and planning a wedding during a pandemic, and they did it beautifully because they truly embody the meaning of a partnership. I am honored to have been able to witness the beginning of their relationship, and I cannot wait to see where the rest of life takes them. So please join me in raising your glass to a lifetime of love, happiness, and partnership. To Allison and Mark.
So that was a wonderfully laid out speech.
Let's go, TJ!
A Boogie and B Boogie, they're all educators, so you know they wrote it down. I didn't write anything down. But I'ma keep it as 100 as I can. I really didn't know what I was gonna say until last night when I was thinking about it, trying to get some sleep at the we all hung out. And I thought about something that Allison said the other day and just passing. She said, she introduced me as Boo, or well, I call him Boo. Some people call him Tiba. I call him Boo. Some people call him Gamal. She said, this is Gamal's best friend from childhood. And I thought about that and I said, that's not true. I met Gamal in high school. We went to Ottawa City College High School. Played ball together, like, did that type of stuff. And I knew Boo from the neighborhood. We all caught the same bus and we were friends in passing. And it wasn't until he came up, well, see, I'm a year older than him, and we were on varsity football together. And because we lived in the same neighborhood, we always caught the bus together after practice. And think about Gamal that I love and caught instantly was how he would ride for his friends and the sincerity he had when he became close to you. What I loved about him more than anything was, though me and him are alike, we're very different in our personality. It was always respect for each other. It was respect and love for the personalities of who we are. And I'll quickly tell a quick story from one of the bus rides. And this is when I knew he was my guy. We used to catch the bus home, and I remember one day we caught the bus home from school after practice. And this, I would say, was 1998. And we came to his house, because that's where we would go after, and we went Ray Mom's refrigerator. Appreciate you, Mom. And then we turned on The Box, which was a music video spot. And this video came on, it was Juvenile. You never heard of this guy, Juvenile. And it was this song called High. This guy's from New Orleans. And he was just, it was different. And I remember both of us looked at each other and was like, this song isn't gonna work. These people are not gonna be around that. 3 weeks later, this was like the biggest song on in the whole school and the whole neighborhood. And I remember us looking at each other and going, you know, like, okay, I guess we were wrong. And from that song, it was just like, and from that song, from what we remember, you know, from that, it was just like, we just clicked. And that was kind of when I realized, like, though we're different in a lot of ways, I love this guy. And think about Ava, Allison. I saw somebody that completed him. And all the things that, you know, they have a lot of opposite, they have a lot of opposite personality traits. But when I saw them together, I saw that she was perfect for him. And with her decisiveness, he's also decisive in his thought process. It just worked. And it's been a pleasure just to watch them grow. You know, I watched them mature together. As like I said, they planned a wedding in the pandemic. And just watching their relationship and the process, and myself just looking at them as a role model in that situation, like when it comes to having a relationship and building. I watched them go through, just do it the right way, with counseling, so they could be the best for each other. And to me, that's amazing. So, I say all that, I ramble a little bit, but I say all that to say, this is my guy, that's been my guy, that's my rollie. He brought Allison into the picture, she also became my rollie. Anything they need, if I can provide, I got it. And I ask that everybody that's here support this couple and family, because they are a beautiful couple, and they're somebody we should all set our marks to. So, to the Gordons. Deaf man, salute, brother.
Shout out High Deaf. That's a song.
We are so happy for you and Gamal, and wish you a lifetime of happiness.
We love you guys.
Happy for my cousin that he's, you know, getting married. You know, I know it's been a long time. You know, for him is a very big day for him, and I'm here to, you know, help him celebrate it. You know, and I'm happy for him.
Okay, so I'm gonna be saying the toast first. Then Ari's going. So, when my dad first introduced us to Allison, I'm going to be completely honest, I was a little standoffish, just a little bit. And over time, I grew to love and care for Allison and see her as, second mom. And through 2020 and what's this year? 2022. We spent so much time together. Like, we had so much fun and did so many crazy things. Like indoor skydiving. And I'll always love and care about Allison in a way. I don't think anyone else will, because she will always have a special place in my heart.
Love you so much. Keep God first.
Let it go, Alexandra! When to grab on them legs, man. We've been waiting for a reason. God is good. Look at him, look at him.
Y'all make some noise for TJ.
And I'm so happy you guys got married.
You
guys look beautiful. And also, Allison, I saw how you reacted with my son. If you ever want to babysit, that would be great. I love y'all.
What's up, man? It's Manny here for the wedding. Just want to say congratulations to my bro, cousin, Tiva, and Allison. You know, he the oldest of the bunch, and he set the example for all of us. I'm the youngest, so I got something to look forward to. I just hope y'all have a wonderful life together, and I'm always be here for you.
Congratulations. Rest of y'all lives, and thank you. That's it.
It's your favorite cousins. Congrats, Miss Gordon. We love you.
Congratulations.
Hey, Chris, we going up from here. What is it?
Hi, Allison. Hi, Gamar. I want to say congratulations. It was a beautiful wedding. I love y'all, and I wish y'all a blessed, prosperous, healthy, safe life. I'm
Excited for the both of them, you know, they the big up, you know what I'm saying?
Hey, the oldest, so you know what I'm saying? He set an example for all of us. I'm the youngest of the crew, so man, to much life, I ain't got no drink, but much life to them, you know.
And pretty more, you know, good wishes for them, you know what I'm saying? I wish them the best marriage, you know.
It's gonna be the best marriage, basically. First in the family, so it's lit.
Thank you. shine the shit. I'm fresh up in this bitch. Now freak your girl, never keep your girl. When I give you back your back, was that your girlfriend? Watch me with my girlfriend.
Hey, Gamal and Allison, I am so glad that y'all are together. Perfect. Thank you.
To our nephew, congrats. Love forever.
This is the beginning of a beautiful thing and something strong. It's go time for hit from now until forever. Love you.
To have and to hold, until death do us part. No one could ever interrupt the beats of our hearts. This is gonna last.